Hey guys, welcome back. I'm sorry I haven't been doing more videos, especially on prepping, but I've been incredibly busy at work, and I gotta tell you, I wish I had more things to do around here, because I often relied a lot on my environment to come up with ideas for videos, and when you're in a place where there's not a lot to do, it's not a lot going on, it's hard to really come up with ideas. What I might end up having to do, what I really want to do, is go down to Nashville for some visits, for some trips, and see what's going on down there. I'm sure I can come up with a lot more things there. I want to check out Lexington, but definitely Nashville. Wherever I go, I want to make it worthwhile. Okay, it has to be worthwhile. It has to be a lot going on. You guys know I like museums. You guys know I like aquariums, animals, zoos. I like art, performing art, music. Things like that, dance, ballet, so that would probably be more like Miami and New York and Chicago. But anyway, I definitely have to get out there and see some different locales. Probably got to travel a good distance, but I got to get that vehicle running right. I've made some changes so far, some upgrades. I actually got a new drag link. I've been working on the front end of the vehicle, and I haven't been working on it. I paid a certified mechanic to work on it. He's been helping me out, man. He's a really good guy. I hope he's watching this video. He's been doing really good work. He replaced the drag link, the idle arm on the passenger side. He's going to replace the idle arm. Idler arm on the driver's side. There was an issue that we ran into. Essentially, on the driver's side, it looks like it was an assembly, idler arm bracket assembly that had a problem. It was really worn out. So, in order to really do things right, he recommended replacing that. So that's something I'm going to do. And once I do that, I'm going to actually get the steering wheel and get the whole vehicle aligned correctly. But this is stuff I have to do to really get it aligned correctly. And I'm looking forward to doing so, because I just want a vehicle that is reliable, a vehicle that I don't have to, you know, cross my fingers every time I turn it on. Oh, and there's the center console. Man, I gotta tell you, I've been carrying my gun in the center console because Kentucky law dictates that you have to put your firearm in the center console or somewhere in some compartment that was built into the vehicle, an original compartment, center console, something like that. And that's basically Kentucky law right there. I've been working on getting my concealed carry permit here in the state of Kentucky. I had one for the state of Michigan, but I lost it when I came here. The second you switch over your license, you lose your concealed carry permit, and you have to start the whole process over here all over again right here. And what that means is you have to, well, for one thing, it's not called CPL, concealed pistol license, like in Michigan. Down here in Kentucky is actually called carrying concealed deadly weapons permit, so, and it includes obviously firearms, but also includes knives and other tools as well. So it's pretty interesting, a little advantage. But the problem is that the whole process I had to go through it all over again, which meant I had to sign up for that $75 class, a lot cheaper than Michigan. Michigan, it would have been $125 to $150 class. You go to the class, 6-hour class, you fill out the form, you take the little test. Once you pass that, the instructor essentially sends the information to the state government. The government waits, it takes about 2 weeks or so for the government to send you a certificate saying that, hey, you completed the training. You take that certificate all the way up to your local sheriff's department, which in my case was 30 miles away. and you fill out more paperwork, and it's just one sheet of paper, and you give them a $20 money order and a $40 money order to two different organizations to process your application. So then they send it in, and you wait another 2 weeks. Actually, mine came in less than like 2 or 3 weeks. Those were actually pretty quickly. You wait a little bit longer, and then they send you a notice, which I received today, saying that, hey, well, you can come up here and pick up your license. So that's what I received today. And now I have to drive another 30 miles back up there to Pikeville or whatever to the state police and get up and actually get my license. So, yeah, it's a sort of dragged out process. I don't see why you can't just do a background check right there on the spot in one day, one instance. I mean, come on. I mean, I've gone through so many background checks, you know, buying guns. And it's so funny when I hear all these anti-gun people talking about, the Republicans in the NRA are against background checks. Like, shut up. Okay, I've been through more background checks than most government employees. I mean, all the guns I bought. And plus, when you have a CPL, they do an automatic background check on you periodically anyway. I think it's like once a month. So it's just, I've had one since 2011. Question of the day, which city should I visit? You guys know what I'm into. I like performing arts. I like music, animals, all those things, you know. I like especially art museums. I love that stuff. Where should I go, you know, that's somewhat close to here? You know, should I go to New York? Should I go to Chicago? Should I go to Nashville? I hear there's nothing like Nashville. Is that city worth stopping and buying? What about Lexington? What about Miami? Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.